Welcome to this afternoon session. Yes, we have a very eminent speaker on a very eminent subject, which is principles and aspects of and legal challenges of mercury used in medicine and its legal challenges. I welcome Professor Anand Kumar Chaudhary from the BHU, this eminent university here, and he's of the Department of Pharmacology,
Ayurvedic Pharmaceutics,
and specialized in this field. So welcome, please.
Good afternoon. Thanks, Chair Dr. Aswell, for inviting me to discuss some issues which are very much close to our heart, just our 5-minute discussion. And we concluded to be agree on the many issues. Our thought process are similar for the all these mercurial compounds which have been assigned to me to interact with you for the next 30 minutes. Friends, my qualification to speak on this issue is that I'm a professor in a central university of the Government of India, which is ranking first, second, or third, top three orders on all accounts, all across country comparatively to all Indian universities and known as Banaras Hindu University. It is 20 kilometers from here. If you have any one of you have time and want to visit the 130 departments, 17 faculties, 5 institutes, 2,500 teachers, 25,000 students. It is just 20 kilometers from here. And I welcome you if you can visit the Banaras Hindu University. It has completed 100 year in the 2016. It was established before independence in the 1916. With this introduction, and there, the faculty of Ayurveda has been established by our founder in the 1922. And from that period, we are making all Ayurvedic medicines, having the all ingredients from the metals, gold, silver, iron, copper, and of course, the mercury. And with a particular phenomenon. So with the introduction of our university, I wish to start the interaction, and all of first, I wish to congratulate everyone here. For information, how many of you is knowing this particular fellow, Dr. Donson, from Dharamshala? What is specific about him? He has been awarded one of the highest civilian award by the Government of India, that is the Padma Shri. So I congratulate everyone here and all the system of the Sogaripa, which this is the first recognition by the Government of India. Sogaripa system is recognized by 2012, but a physician of this particular system with the highest civilian award of the Padma Shri, this is the first time. So I congratulate you all, and this is the third international conference on the Tibetan medicine where we are gathered. And friends, if you see this one, the last, it is the heading is the proposed ban on mercury may hit Ayurveda adversely. Because see, in the Ayurvedic system of medicine or the Sovaripa or the Tibetan system of medicine in other name or the Chinese medicines or the Sri Lankan medicine or the Bhutani medicines or the Nepali medicines, I wish to say in this Asian continent, this mercury has been used as a medicine, as a magic remedy since thousands of years. And each and every system, what I counted right now, have some similarity in its pharmaceutical processes. And these are the pharmaceutical processes which are making this highly industrial toxic mercury into a form of a magic medicines. So let us see how we are doing this particular thing. So the origin of the as I am a student of Ayurveda, I will try to correlate with the Sogaripa or the Tibetan medicine. And I remember the first seminar when this both were compared and the government of India recognized our Rupa as a system of medicine, that place was also in the Sarnath, and I was participatory in that particular movement also. And we speak and compare the pharmaceutics of the Ayurveda and the pharmaceutics of the Soga Rupa at that time. See, Ayurveda is mainly prominently practicing herbal medicines, all Brihatrayi, perhaps you are knowing, Charak Sangita, Sushrut Sangita, Ashtang Hriday, is full of only herbal medicines. Yes, there are 10% about some herbal mineral preparations, and mercury was in a very, very lesser amount, negligible. In the first three good classical textbooks of Ayurveda, practice of the mercury as a medicine was negligible. I'm pointing out it. But meanwhile, one Acharya Nagarjuna, is trying to get this mercury into form of a medicine. And he took, disciples took 500 years to make this mercury in the form of the medicine. And they started in the 5th AD. They completed their all inventions, all dosage forms, into the 10th AD. And looking to all its clinical efficacy, quick responses, wider therapeutic range, longer self-life, good palatability, Ayurveda accommodated, amalgamated Rasasastra, that is the mercurial preparations, completely. And if you see the 11th AD, all books of Ayurveda having combinations, herbal as well as mercurial, as well as the herbal mineral. So this is the turning point of the 11th AD, of the 500 year research by the Rasasastra people, and the beginner was Acharya Nagarjuna. So nowadays we are moving for the advanced Ayurveda with all scientific validation of the mercurial preparations, herbal mineral preparations. And these are the books, Ras Rasamucha of the 11th century. This is the 20th century book. If you see, these are available in the English also. All mercurial procedures, all therapeutic applications with the different herbal decoctions are quoted very much in the Rastarangadi. And these both are making pharmaceutics and the therapeutics of the mercurial preparation at excellent way. So anyone is interesting to study or to know much more about this, I shall try for the only 20-25 minutes. Just go these two books. These are available. Rasrat Samuchya and the Rastarangadi. The English translation is also available. So what are the doses form? Friends, you are knowing well, there are injections, tablets, syrup, lozenges, pastries, intramuscular, intravenous injection, different doses forms of the allopathic medicine. In the same way, Ayurveda is also having a lot of doses forms of the herbal, the powder, the decoction, the confectionery, the medicinal oil, the medicinal ghee, many more. I'm just leaving all that aside. I'm concentrating on the mercurial preparations. The mercury is also modified into these five different forms. The Kharaliyaras, the mercury and the sulfur, triturated, pure mercury, pure sulfur, after the process of the purification, triturated, and then mixed with the herbal powders. Those are known as the Kharaliyaras. Then it is the purpati. It is a very specific arrangement at the temperature level of the 120 degree only, with the immediate cooling, and the product is known as purpati. And here only two ingredients, that is the parat, gandhak, mercury, and the sulfur. Triturated, melted, and immediate cooling with the help of the some additional things. And that is known as the purpati. It is very good for the gastrointestinal disorders. Then kupi pakoras. Friends, this is the most complicated, most specialized dosage forms of the mercury. We prepared it into the graded intermittent temperature series of the 200 degree, 400 degree, 600 degree centigrade finally. It took 24 hours and a special arrangement in a bottle. Nowadays we are using muffle furnaces, and it is known as the kupi pakoras because it is prepared in a bottle. Kupi means bottle. Then the potali, this is the 350 degree. At the 350 degree temperature, we prepare it in another specific way that I'm not going to detail right now. Druti, it is the melted form of the mercury and the sulfur. What I wish to say that these pharmaceutics are very, very individualized, very specific, written in our classics with all kinds of the herbs used there. That is also very much specific, the temperature ranges, the equipments, and following that, one can make, I used to say, industrially toxic mercury into a medicinal magic mercury. But these things are required. See, this is the COPP, Certificate of Pharmaceutical Product, allotted by the CDSCO, it is the Government of India organization, Central Drug Standard Control Organization. This is permitting export of Ayurvedic medicines to abroad. My dream is what? And that may be true with you all. Nowadays, COPP is available only for the herbal preparations, right? People are exporting it, the herbal mineral, such as the country Switzerland. There are the 16 countries in the total European Union which are accepting Ayurvedic medicines as medicine. Rest, it is not. It is either dietary supplement or the food supplement or in another form or in that way or this way, not as a medicine. The COPP is there, but after knowing all these things, this site is giving you all the information of the Government of India. Our dream may be true if we go scientifically, that a day will come, of course, after one decade or the two decade or early, the export of mercurial preparations from India to abroad. So this is just a scenario, what is going on here in this part of the earth. India is a large country, and here the different practices of Ayurveda, even the different tribes, even the different ethnic population. So everything is different. But if you count about the mercurial preparations, in the east of India, west part of the India, north part of India, south part of India, it is equally acceptable. If you see in the Andhra Pradesh, the southern region, there is the Raswagbhat in the 11th century. If you see in the west, that is the Gujarat and the Maharashtra, there are in the 16th century, the book Ayurved Prakash. If you go deep south, which is purely herbal dominated, even today in the 21st century, some doctors, Dr. Sasi Nachal or the other one, are using these mercurial preparations abundantly reported everywhere with a full safety and efficacy. I wish to submit before you that all across country, known as India, we are practicing mercurial preparations with a confidence for treatment of many chronic diseases. Come to the Asia, if you see Tibet, they are equally rich. I can say there is a claim, Acharya Nagarjun, who introduced us, is a Tibetan monk, and it is up true also. So they are the originator. If you see the Nepal, it is a small country, but its contribution to the exemption of the mercury, what we are talking, chair sir, that role of Nepal is very significant. They were who presented in the EPA, Environmental Protection Agency of the USA, and got mercury exempted for their rituals, traditional uses, then Government of India also there, but Nepal having major share in that exemption, as reported into the Washington Post in the 2016. So come to the Sri Lanka, yes, we are the same, and when I say same, I'm respecting geographical boundaries, but the cultural boundaries, the knowledge, and that is almost equal. China, of course, there is no need to discuss about these people. They are very, very contributing. Yes, I'm serious about it. They are contributing scientifically this all herbal mineral preparations. I will show further two, three papers, all are from Chinese origin. India is also working, but Chinese are ahead. I have to accept it, and I just congratulate them, yes, if they are more serious about the acceptance of the cinnabar mercurial preparation as a global medicine. Next. Yes, what about Europe and the USA? I'm just looking, many of my European friends are here. So I take their permission to speak honestly. What happened there? This is the paper I just quoted. See, my presentation is with you and all the links are given and you can click and get whole information. This is a paper published by one Indian scientist, R.C. Kapoor. He is an astrophysicist having good interest into the rasas, that is the mercurial preparations. He has given good history in that particular paper that Europe also wanted to use mercury as a medicine. Paracelsus tried a lot. The 700 year they tried. And they started using calomel, mercury chloride, for the treatment of some kind of the syphilis or the some kind of the some urinary infections. But, and just some researchers we are interacting with each other from the Europe, they have given the evidence and they published that in the beginning, they also tried to use mercury as a medicine, but this area has developed a specific pharmaceutical procedure that we have called Sodhan, Maran, Sanskar. Next few slides are about those particular pharmaceutical processes. But they, in the Europe, they were not having such kind of the concept which was developed by Acharya Nagarjuna and his disciple of the purification, calcination and the pharmaceutical processes, which are making this mercury free from the toxicity, good as a medicine. They started working on the chloride form and it is highly toxic, whether it is recognized into the Ayurveda medicines too. But Ayurveda, Tibetan, Chinese medicines, Sri Lankan medicines, they converted mercury into the sulfide form. And this inorganic form of the mercury, sulfide form, is least toxic, and the best, having best therapeutic efficacy. Whereas chloride is a highly toxic. Organic form of mercury is highly toxic. So the Asian, I wish to use the word Asian, developed this process of the purification and got mercury into the form of a medicine where Europe felt. Come to the America. This is a paper published into the 1953. And I have a document of the 1926 of the American Defense Library. They are also having 54 pages on the application of the mercurial preparation, that is the calomel. And finally, in the BMJ, in the Lancet, if you see 1950, 1960, they are publishing papers of the toxicity of the mercurial compounds of the calomel. Humbly, I wish to say, they were not able to make alpha cinnabar, beta cinnabar, mercuric sulfides, which can be used as a medicine. They were just concentrated on the oxide form of the mercury or the chloride form of the mercury. So they were not successful in their therapeutic efficacy. Nowadays, their intention are changed. And now they are taking in their laboratory this sulfide form. I will show you a paper in which from a Canadian lab in the 2017 in the August, they published a very scientific paper showing efficacy of the mercurial compounds or the metallic compounds, but few minutes later. So I am trying to emphasize that this particular pharmaceutical panorama, advancement of the Asia, led to the mercury into the medicine. What is that? Kindly just give me 5-10 minutes for that. See here, authentication. We do the quality control of not only the mercury, but all the gold, silver, stannous, lead, iron, whatsoever. There are about 30 biotite, chalcopyrite, gypsum, many more minerals and the metals as a medicines. We do authentication. There are the characteristic features in the procurement. Then the process of the purification or the potentiation. It is the most important. This is the only process which is responsible for this conversion. Then there is a process of the maran at the different temperature level, right from 300 degrees centigrade to the 800 degrees centigrade. And of course, my dear friends, every bhasm, every metallic preparations in the end, we test for the completion test, very scientific on the physicochemical parameters and the biological parameters, And these are discussed into the book of the 11th century. Yes, your final bhasp, fine powder should be so fine, it should be between the furrows of the finger. It should not irritate when you use for the collyrium. It should float on the surface of the water. What they want to say? When they are emphasizing on these completion parameters, they are assuring its nanoparticle size, of course, and then the particular color. And that color is assuring a particular compound. Mercury sulfide in the red color, copper sulfide into the black color, that is the biotite into the just brick color, that is the gold bust into the something yellow color. The color, the particular color is just giving a assurance of a particular compound which is having medicinal use. And the same metal, if the process is different, powder may be different of the different color. Come to the process of the purification. What it does? Yes, it changed physically. It changed that particular compound chemically. It changed its biological characters. And of course, it changes its therapeutic level. So the process of the Shodhan was invented here in this continent. And that is the only thing which makes this mercury into the form of a medicine. Next is very, very scientific. Every one of us is knowing when you are cooking food, what happened. When you are making a synthetic molecule, what happened, what is required. When you are changing any alloy, what happened. So all these things are there. The thermochemistry, which changed gold into the form of the gold oxide, the silver into the form of silver sulfide, mercury, pure mercury into the form of the alpha cinnabar, mercuric sulfide, the quantum of heat which is required, a particular level of the heat, and the, every molecule needs a formation and the summation energy that we just ensure by the different kinds of the put. They are the Mahaput, Gajput, Laguput, Kapotput, all these Baluka put. And see, every put is not applied on every metal. Here is specifically, if you have to prepare iron bust, then you have to go to the 1000 degree Mahaput. If you have to prepare gold bust, then you have to keep yourself into the Kapotput, 300 degree centigrade. So this variation is there, and that is developed by our acharyas there. The conversion, and finally they are making it into the absorption and the assimilation form which is required as a medicine. So the mercury is having some specific characters. That is the way you say sanskar, swedan, mardan, murchan, then the astada sanskar in the last total 18 process. These 18 processes are required for the making of the gold that we are not doing. Cheers, sir. We are just making ourselves limited to the therapeutic purposes, and there are only 8 sanskar. These are the papers published by our Department of Rasas of the Banaras Hindu University. Recently, it is the 2013, first week of the January, that was in the 2013. If you see, we have, that was in 2016. 10 was another paper published into the Journal of Scientific and Industrial Research in the August, and the title was the Ayurvedic Bhasma are the most ancient applicable nanomedicines of the world. And that was in the even Journal of American Biotechnology also. So our department is working in this line. This is paper from our department. And we have tried, we have proved with the collaboration of other departments of our university that all these processes are making bioavailability of the mercury. And this processes are just classical and contemporary methods for conversion of toxic, unstable mercury to safe and the stable mercury. I request all of you to click on that particular paper and go in the detail. Standardization, of course, here is the work which somebody are doing, and it is required to work more. You will be happy to know it that the NIH USA, National Institute of Health, they have made memorandum of understanding with the government of India last year in the February, Ministry of Ayush. USP, United States of Pharmacopoeia, NIH, Ministry of Ayush, as well as the PLIM, Pharmacopoeia Laboratory of the Indian Medicine, for the standardization of the Ayurvedic medicine, specifically of the herbal mineral origin. What does it mean? What is the message? They have conceptualized that the post-antibiotic era, they need some more good medicines. The antibiotic resistance is high. So NIH, in the United States Pharmacopoeia, is making memorandum of understanding with the government of India to get a good quality drug for their citizens after 10 years. So they have started right now. We are the expert of making of these medicines. So they want to learn it, and they want to just prove it on their parameters. Yes, parameters are high, and of course, we do believe we will cope up to that parameters too. So this is the recent publication, yes, 2017, when there is a propaganda that the mercurial medicines are highly toxic, by published into the JAMA research paper by someone, I don't want to name, from the Boston. Government of India published this book. This contains 16 formulations authenticated on the pharmaceutical, biochemical, histological parameters. It is the government publication. All are the mercurial preparations. And having 50 pages for one, all, I repeat, quality control, biochemical parameters, histopathology. And anyone can see how does it work and how safe it is. Of course, Pharmacopoeia Laboratory of Indian Medicine, Government of India, is accounting on the metallurgical, chemical, and the histopathological studies. See what I was appreciating Chinese. These are the regions. See their headings. The bioaccessibility of mercury in selected Ayurvedic medicines. And here also, some paper having some Chinese authors, some American authors, some Indian authors also. And they are trying to say that the mercurial compounds are absorbed into the body, and if it is prepared classically, they are good as a medicine, as any other medicines. So you can go to all these papers, clicking on the link. Time is running, so I'm making short. The therapeutic treasure of research studies, the mercurial profession, all these orders, I have some papers of this particular conference where we are sitting. There are some speakers who are covering all these titles. So this is the name of the drugs which have been studied on the modern parameters. They are in the classics, but they have been scientifically validated, and all are having mercury. All this is having copper. This is having zinc into the incinerated form. But these are scientifically validated, and one can go through it and can believe that yes, if it is the classically prepared, government certified for the quality control, one can use all these. Recent researches, yes, I have just hinted. This is a publication from the Kannada, August 2017. The laboratory is Kannada. Authors are Indians, Chinese, and Canadians. What they are reported, amazing. They work at the mitochondrial level. Sir and Chair Sir and all you learned delegates, they work on the nuclear level, and they proved that the nanoparticles of the Swarna Bhasma, that is the gold, I don't want to use the word as, I prefer to use the word bhasma, that is the Swarna Bhasma, and the synthetically compound gold nanoparticles are entering in these levels and changing all the path and showing effect on it the pharmacological level. What you need more? This is the August 2017 from a Canadian lab. You just take full paper, this is the link, and publish into the Nature, having the highest impact factor. So comparative study on cellular entry of incinerated ancient gold particles, Swarna Bhasma, and chemically synthesized gold particles. We were thrilled, amazed, when this paper was published. Of course, they are using the word Ayurveda, Rasa, Swarna Bhasma, everything, and that is our dream, and they are fulfilling. See, this particular paper, it is also in the 2017, all authors are Chinese, and it is a review of the cinnabar, mercuric sulfide, and the arsenical containing traditional medicines. Here also, they are also trying to say that everything is in tune, in color, and can be used safely. So the safety saga, here, you are from the Bhaktian medicines, and I hope you are knowing. How many of you have the word Jutoi?
Yes, sir.
2 minutes more. This is a Tibetan medicine.
Jutai.
Yeah. And if you see this paper, that is the Sothal. Right? You are using it? So both are here. Time is less. But if you see the recent papers, 2000, this is the 16, this is the 17, 2016 and 17, and they are proving that these medicines are as safe as any good medicine. So what about the legal? Mercury band, everyone is knowing. And this is a movement from our department. We got succeeded for the exemptions. The procurement practice is permitted even after 2020 for the medicinal purposes. The legal status is given by the Government of India. And this is the Down to Earth magazine. And here it is said very clearly that for medicinal and the religious purposes, mercury will be available into the Asian market after all ban on the thermometer, barometer, and the dental, and the many thing more. So the last, the conclusion, the health, wellness, aging are unique concept of the rasayana, and all rasayana drugs are in having prominency mercurial medicines. And this is published on 25th February. This is the most recent. And this quality, safety, efficacy, self-life, economy, regulations, pharmacovigilance. And how many of you are knowing this? Have you visited this site? Yeah? And this is showing that the toxicity study of the mercurial compounds. You the, also working on the same way, we all together working with the same objective, that to prove that the classically prepared mercurial medicines are safe. Finally, chair, permit me just 10 seconds. This is today's newspaper of this area, having 7 crore readership.
Okay.
This is the in Hindi, Dainik Jagran. Today, you can see in your library. What they are saying, the Vedic Gyan ko Vigyan sabit karne mein jute bharte. I am translating into the English. The all Vedic knowledge of the country is going to be translated into the scientific knowledge by the top premier institutions of the India, like Indian Institute of Technology, Indian Institute of Science, which are having world ranking 300 or 300. And this is the today's classification from the Government of India. Means good days are coming for us, whole science is coming to us, and they will do something for us. And finally, I'm thankful to the Dr. Lobsang, Dr. Sering, and the chair, Dr. Sarval, and you audience, and all team of the third act. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Chaudhary. Thank you. We have time for some short questions. Anybody here for a question? Or was everything
I can
so
welcome any question.
So clear that, so maybe I have a question. So is it really clear that Indian government will allow mercury use for medicine, or is this just a wish?
No. Indian government has allowed it, and we are preparing. Otherwise, there will be lock in our department.
Okay. Okay. So, but
Indian government has no hesitation. Even the Indian government has published good manufacturing practices for the resource of these mercurial preparations separately.
Yes.
And the separate laws for it.
So you have no problem getting raw material.
Yeah.
Raw material is enough.
Raw material will be imported, and for the medicinal and the other purposes, the Government of India is bound to make it available for us.
Okay. Because the main sources where the mercury is...
In Italy. In Spain.
In Spain, this is closed down. So.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, any, Eric?
Yeah, sir, first, thank you for a beautiful presentation.
Thank you.
But can you clarify a little bit, so in India now, there are many large Ayurvedic pharmaceutical companies that produce, you know, rasa, basma, parid, kalpanas, you know, and, it seems that some of them may be cutting corners as far as not doing the traditional Shodhana practices in the proper way. Maybe there's some permission to use some other things to make seemingly bioidentical end products. So what's your view on that? and the safety of large scale production, you know, rasa compounds?
Thanks. This is a very relevant question, and we are working on this. Of course, we are preparing anything in the laboratory for 1 kg, 2 kg, that is no problem. But when you are supposed to prepare 100 kg and the 1 quintal and the tons in the 5 year or the per annum, like that, there is a problem. So what we are doing it, we are setting a range, the Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia of India, volume 7, part 1. It is a government official book. There are the 9 volumes, and the volume 7 is for the herbal mineral preparations. There are the ranges given for the quality control and the parameters of the safety. Every manufacturer which has been licensed under the GMP of the Rasaushadhi separately is supposed to prepare all those medicines on that particular line. But the problem, the real problem is here, there are the few company who which are willing to adapt it classically. Otherwise, for the cost and for the lesser time to get more benefit, because if you go one classical put, it will take 3 days. And if you are going to prepare 20 put for the larger, it will take longer. Means longer labor, longer economical expenditure. So they are making something shortcuts. But when we come for the completion test and the analytical parameters, if anyone will do the shortcuts, they will be failed there. And they will be checked. So if you see, I have just written, it may be published, that just purchase the Ayurvedic medicines of the herbo-mineral origin only having Ayush premium certification by the Government of India, Ayush standard certification by the Government of India, only GMP certification is not sufficient to believe on them. So my view is that there is a need of precaution, because in the interest of money, people can compromise life of a human. So your worry is very right, accurate, I appreciate it, but we are trying to get it at everything on standards, and hopefully we will succeed. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much. I think, thank you so much, and I think this concludes this session.
So on behalf of